living in sin. And a guy came to me with a sandwich board on with a bunch of Bible scriptures rebuking us for drunkenness, rebuking us for sexual morality, and I argued with him. I was the heckler. I was you. I say, no, you're wrong, man. You're judgmental. Oh, look at you, man. You're hateful. I'm a Christian. I can do what I want. It's God's grace. But then I went in there, that bar that night, and I started to think about what that guy did. And then when I started to get judged, God started to judge me. God's going to start judging you, young people, and you're going to remember this day. You're going to be like, man, I'm in some pain right now.
Oh, past 1:30? Actually, I'm going to do it without the bullhorn. I'm not going nowhere. You guys need to wake up and understand that in the state that you're living in right now.
I love being gay. I love being gay, and you will not change that.
I love watching people get changed from their life of sin, like me. I was changed. If you don't get, if you don't turn from your sin, then you will pay in hell. Hell is a real place for sinners. You guys have a conscience. You know. Right, love. Love, it says, rejoices not in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Love is patient. I'm very patient with you guys. I probably should have left hours ago, but I waited it out. I'm bearing your sin. I don't want to be around this woman. I don't want to be around this half-naked woman. I'm bearing it because I know you need to hear. It's lewd. It's for your husband. It's for your husband.
Fuck you!
You need to get married. You need to be faithful to the opposite sex. Make sure whoever you marry is a Christian first. God wants me here today. God sent me here today that you might become like God. The Bible says, imitate me as I imitate God. I'm imitating Jesus Christ.
You
are not. Yes, I am. He did. It says it in judge. This woman has a good question. Hold on. Hold on. This woman thinks that Jesus would not do what I'm doing. But the Bible says, the Bible says in John chapter 7, verse 7, Jesus said, as many as, he said that I came to the world and they hate me because I testify that their deeds are evil. Jesus went into the world and testified that their deeds were evil.
Not welcome here.
No, no, I'm gonna stay. I'm gonna stay, okay? So everyone knows I am not going anywhere. Why won't you leave your sin? Why won't you leave the ungodly influences in your life?
I love wearing revealing clothes. You need to fuck off.
Hey, I don't want danger to happen to you. You're sowing to the flesh, you're gonna reap corruption. So to the spirit, right. A broken spirit, God will not despise. You don't understand. You need to break your heart. What about your heart? Is there no heart in you? Don't you want to hold a little baby? A little baby heart? They need you. The kids need responsible women, responsible men to be fathers. Be an example to the young people, the Bible says. To be an example to the flock. Yes, when the chief overseer comes. Wrong! Wrong example! Wrong example! I'm an example of God. I say be chaste, a homemaker. Be a homemaker. Look, make your home. Make your home beautiful. Beautify the home. Stay at home. Her feet do not stay at home, the Bible says. You guys are wandering. You guys are lurking in secret places. Come home to God. God will establish you, forgive you, change you. God can take those evil desires out of your heart, put in you a heart of flesh. Look, I was a wicked sinner. When I got saved, I threw my television out. I threw my world of music out. I threw my marijuana out. I threw my pornography out. That was a hard one. I actually struggled with that one. There are a lot of demons behind pornography. Don't mess with pornography, folks. All the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 7, I think it is, it says, she has slain many wounded. All who are slain by her were strong men. She lies in wait as for a victim. She increases the unfaithful among men. The prostitutes. The prostitutes. You guys are giving it up for nothing. You're giving it up for no money. Fear will never fill the lust of the flesh. For the spirit lusts against the flesh, and the flesh against the spirit, they are contrary.
Dude, I know what that shit's like.
I am filled with the Holy Spirit. I know that you need forgiveness. You need forgiveness for your masturbation. You need a cleansing from Jesus Christ. The word of God's power to cleanse your soul. The word of God is quick and powerful. Again, but guess what? I got more knowledge. Have you guys heard the same Bible verse twice yet? Because I give you knowledge. A wise man useth knowledge, the Bible says. A wise man useth knowledge. The Bible says a wise man increases strength by understanding. It says his house is established. It is filled by knowledge with all kinds of precious and pleasant riches. Yes, by wisdom, it says, wage your own war. And the multitude of counselors, there is safety. I got a multitude of Bible verses for my counselors. You, are you sure about that?
Yes.
You don't come up against the Bible. The Bible's the word of God.
I am full of love. You are full of love.
The Bible's going to be here after you die.
The Bible's
going to be. Oh. They trust in that word. Men gave their lives for the word of God. The testimony of Jesus. Spirit of prophecy. Hey, the Bible's greater than you. The Bible's greater than your wisdom. The Bible has the wisdom of this life. The word of God is written in the word. God has a mouth. And he calls those things as though they not, and that are not as though they were. God can call you righteous, and you be righteous. When you get humble, say, God, have mercy on me. You say, God, have mercy on me, a sinner. But if you harden your heart, but if you get full of sin, demons, all of us are made in the image of God. All of us, but you've turned it to a graven image. We're all created in the image of God, but you guys in your sin are turning it into a graven image. A graven image.
Everybody's watching, but no one's believing. You might
sex!
As well go.
Sex out of marriage!
Awesome.
Sex out of marriage! Awesome. Graven images. Graven images on the internet, folks. You guys are watching those weird videos on YouTube, man. Graven images. You know what I'm talking about. They do all the cinematography. And all this ungodly witchcraft. The Bible says, mistress of sorceries. She sells nations by her harlotries and families by her sorceries. But the seductive harlots, in the multitude of her harlotries, are the seductive harlot. She's a witch, that seductive harlot. She's a witch. She manipulates and contrives a scheme. But God wants to build you up. He wants to train you. The Bible's, no, it's for your own good. It's for your own good. You know you're going to die. It's for your own good. You're not ready to die in your sin. I'm ready to die because I know I'm going to go be with Christ. This life.
Go then. Go be with Christ.
Not my time yet. It's not my time yet.
Why don't we hurry it up?
Hurry it up. Hurry it up.
It's more needful for me to remain for you. It's more needful for me to remain here with you young people.
You're
the next generation.
Their friends are making fun of you.
I am the generation ahead of you. You're the next generation. I didn't know it was going to be this bad. It's gotten worse. It's gotten worse since I was a young person. You know, when I went back to Michigan State, last year, and man, there were women out there. There were women out there that were worse, way worse than what these women are doing to me. They were grabbing me. What's beautiful? Jesus is beautiful. Jesus is what's beautiful.
Jesus is dead. He's gone.
Jesus is gay? Don't blaspheme Jesus, man. Look, say what you want about me, but don't blaspheme Jesus. You know what? The grave is empty. Jesus' tomb is empty to this day.
No, it's not.
If you're a real person, you know.
You're alive today because Jesus was risen from the grave. Jesus was risen from the grave. Therefore, we live to him.
All right, time.
Folks, you need Jesus. I don't come here my own accord. I don't preach myself. I preach Jesus Christ. You need Jesus. Hatred for sin, yes.
No.
I hate sin.
No judgment. Why do you judge gays?
Jesus actually said in John 7, this woman said, God preaches no judgment. Jesus said,
nobody can judge except
judge with righteous judgment. There's different kinds of judgment. There's different kinds of judgment. I'm giving you a kind of judgment today. It's a warning. A warning. It's a display of the life that you're in today. You need a warning of the judgment that's going to come. God is the ultimate judge. That's why you fear God.
God can judge. You can't.
The Bible says, if you call upon God, who judges each man's work without partiality, conduct yourself throughout your time of your stay here in fear. Fear God. He's going to judge you by the word of God. God is going to judge. Yes, I agree. I'm not judged. I'm not in these sins that I'm preaching against. I'm not in those things any longer. I was in the filthiness of this world. I've been washed from my filthiness.
I'm sorry.
You need to love Jesus.
I love Jesus
too. You can be delivered, man. No, you're living in sin. You should love your wife. Love one woman. Be faithful to her. Be faithful to one woman. You live in a world of sin. I was like you. I was lost in my pornography. Lost. Lost in my sex out of marriage. Lost. The Bible says if our gospel is hidden, it is hidden to them that are lost. Your conscience bears witness, man. I just preached about your conscience. Look, I wanted God to be understanding, let me live in sin, but I ended up with heart failure because of my sin.
Why did it work?
I took a big swig of beer in a bar one night, laughed at a guy, and choked. I was dying.
Because you don't know how to chug, bro.
God didn't want me to die. He raised me up for this work that you guys are hearing today. I'm a sign. I'm a sign to this generation. You can be saved. You don't have to be a heathen.
I'm gay and I'm proud.
When I got saved, I threw my television out. I threw my worldly music out. I turned my sin out. They didn't hear it. There's new people here. There's new people here. I study the Word of God. I'm a believer of the Word of God. I worship God in the Spirit. I'm not a hypocrite.
I'm gay.
The things I'm telling you, I'm not doing in secret. See, that's what these people, you guys are doing a lot of sins in secret.
What if you were born in
India? Admit it. Just admit it. Just confess it. Confess that you're in need of Jesus. You can have grace. You can be like me for it. You can have grace from God. What's your question?
What
if you're born in India? Okay.
God.
Then you'd have a different level of judgment.
So you just go to hell, right?
You have a different level of judgment.
Okay.
But you're not born in India, so you don't have that kind of judgment.
What if I wasn't really?
You've heard the Bible. You've heard the Bible, and you've denied it.
No, I haven't.
Those people,
haven't?
You're hearing it right now?
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. What? I'm not quoting the Bible? I'm not quoting the scriptures to you guys today?
No one fucking cares!
He said he didn't hear the Bible today, so I said that.
During the time of Noah, during the time of Noah, nobody knew about rain. There was no rain in the time of Noah. There was never a flood. There was never rain. And God showed Noah that there would be... There's no rain. There was a mist coming up from the earth. There was a canopy around the earth. There was no rain on the earth. Everything was preserved. People lived to be like 900 years old.
Holy shit!
But you know what happened? You know what happened? Once Noah, once the flood came, they saw something that they never seen before, a flood. You know, I know there's a hell. I've never seen it, but I know in my spirit, I know in my soul there is a hell, and you know there is too. You know there's condemnation. You can honestly ask yourself if you're right with God, and you know the answer. You know if you're really going to be able to stand before Jesus. Bible says in the book of Matthew, he says, pray that you be able to escape all these things, and you'll be able to stand before the Son of Man. Are you going to be counted worthy to stand before the Son of Man? Are you going to be counted worthy? Is everything a joke? You know, who's going to be laughing? You know what the Bible says? It says the wicked, they say this, let us break their bonds in two and cast their cords from
us. Fuck yeah!
You know what
preach that shit, man!
You know what it says God will do? It says God will laugh at them.
Fuck yeah!
He will speak to them in his wrath.
For a reason.
And he will distress them in his deep displeasure. Okay, God will laugh.
Yeah,
you think it's a joke, but you know what? On Judgment Day, God will be the one laughing. And you know what the devil's going to say? The devil's going to say the joke was on you. You were tricked. You were deceived. Yes. You know, happy little minions doing whatever the devil wants to die in your sin. You know, the Bible says you're either a slave to righteousness or you're a slave to sin. One or the other. Slave to sin. You're either what? What's that?
Exactly.
This is how God says to do it. What God? What God? God who?
God.
Oh no. My God doesn't say that.
Does God not exist?
What's his name? What's the name of the God you're talking about? What's the name of the God you're talking about? What's the name of the God you're talking about?
Jesus.
No, Jesus is the living Jesus Christ. If you read John chapter 1, it says that Jesus, it says the Word became flesh and dwelt among us. Jesus became flesh, the living Word of God. The Word of God condemns homosexuality. Okay? Jesus is as good as his word. Jesus is the Word, and Jesus condemns homosexuality. Okay, so who? What?
What?
1 Corinthians 6:9.
6:9.
First chapter of Timothy. Leviticus 19. Look it up. Who do you think Jesus is anything different than what the Bible says?
What? Yeah. Yeah, what the fuck is going through your mind right now, people?
So you can sit here, and say, my God, I'm supposed to do something different. Sit here and say, I'm supposed to do something different, but this is the love of God.
Do it right.
The Bible says in Proverbs 27:5, it says, open rebuke is better than secret love. Rebuke is better than secret love.
Close your mouth.
You guys need a rebuke. You need to repent.
Yeah, repent.
That's just the bottom line.
Repent. What the fuck?
You guys, it's so funny. He's cussing. Wow. Ha ha. You guys laugh all the time. Oh, he said another cuss word. You guys see how deceived you are? You know, the Bible says that mockers would come in the last days. What?
Well, I mean, he's gotten his ass.
No, I have a business. Actually, I have a business. My own business, and I do pretty good.
It's called Team Jesus what? Preachers. Look him up
what?
On YouTube.
From around here. No. What?
Hey, I'll take that shit.
Oh yeah, and he told him to repent. Jesus came out of the wilderness. You're not a Christian. You're a fake Christian. You're believing though. You're a fake Christian. Yeah, I am. You don't obey the Bible. What kind of Christian doesn't believe the Bible?
Go fuck yourself today.
Well, if you believe the Bible, you believe that Jesus preached repentance.
Even your hype man hates you now.
John 7:7. Jesus said, the world can't hate you, but it hates me because I testify of it that its deeds are evil. Jesus testified that the deeds of this world are evil.
Fuck yeah.
Okay, and you need to repent.
Repent that shit.
Jesus said, I didn't come to call the righteous, but sinners to repentance. He came to call sinners to repentance. That's what Jesus said.
What do you do with
here.
What I'm calling sinners to repentance.
Okay, but you're not doing it in a loving way.
Okay, so what do I need to do?
Talk to people. Be friends.
I'm sitting here talking to people while I'm being insulted constantly, and you blame me. This is how it always is. You blame the preacher. He loves his enemies for now. Okay, but what happens when they die? What happens when the homosexual dies? What happens when the homosexual dies?
God talks to them. You aren't God.
You won't say. You're not a Christian. You're fake. You're not born again. You won't say.
I have a suggestion. There are the people that sit in the chairs.
Yeah.
Like, if you talk to them, they'll tell you about God. Have you tried that?
Look, I've done everything. I'm not the aggressive one. You're standing behind me the sign with this on. You're a hypocrite. You're a hypocrite.
Yeah, no.
You're a hypocrite.
God, too, actually. Like, I'm an atheist.
Yeah, you're a hypocrite, man.
How am I a hypocrite?
See, that makes sense that you're an atheist because you don't obey the truth.
How am I a hypocrite?
And now you're being a hypocrite. You're not obeying truth.
How am I a hypocrite?
Hey,
you're telling
what?
Me I'm being
fuck
aggressive,
off.
But you're standing right behind
fuck
me with my gun.
I'm standing here
fuck
with
off.
Written words.
Fuck
I wouldn't
off.
Even.
Words mean
fuck
literally
off.
Nothing.
Okay, so then why are you so mad at me, hypocrite? Why are you so upset with me then, hypocrite?
I'm not upset with you. I'm giving you a
suggestion. Well, words do mean something, and you're a liar, see?
Because you're a bitch.
See, it goes to show you your lies are wrong.
Fuck you.
Words don't mean nothing to me, especially your words. You need to repent.
Fuck you.
You need to turn to Jesus. It's not my words.
Fuck you.
It's God.
Fuck you.
Yeah. And you know what? If you don't obey God's words.
Fuck you. Fuck you.
Is the love of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
And thank you, and I can hear that love through your voice.
Well, that's good. Now, why don't you follow that love instead
because,
of...
Because then why you don't, fuck it up.
Now, you guys, why don't you repent?
Is
that's
that
the whole
friend?
Point.
Is that your friend over there?
I'm not.
No, definitely not you.
Oh, well, no.
Is that your friend over there?
Yeah, actually, I'm his boyfriend. That's the...
No, I feel like...
That's a very modern Christian.
You know, I'm actually...
He's the Christian that brings others towards Christ.
Exactly.
And you are pushing people away.
Well, y'all can say that, but you ain't even pursuing Christ, so what's even matter?
You know what we do,
because you guys follow opinions and not the Bible. Fake. Well, you guys aren't listening to him, because if you did, you repent and become a Christian.
Okay, let's
you start dressing modestly. You start obeying the Bible. So really, what does it matter whether I say it or him, if you guys just hear it and say, oh, I like him better, and you don't repent of your sins?
Coming from him than you.
Well, look, you guys are, see, you're all wrapped in this acceptance. I like how he says it. You know, he came off good. Thank you. You know, I'll listen to him.
If I came over here to learn about Jesus and I hear you being hateful towards all these people, I'm not going to want that.
Well, you don't understand love and you don't understand hate.
You don't understand love.
You guys cuss at me. You mock me. Everything I give you is from the Bible. And you guys disregard it.
I never cursed that you guys.
Okay.
And I got
and you say it's hate because it's correction. You think correction is hate?
No.
Well, then why are you saying I'm hateful?
He's not hating.
What? Because of my delivery? Is anybody else here hateful? Are they hateful?
Yes.
So everybody's hateful.
Bye, guys.
Okay, so it's my fault that they're hateful.
He's not
coming up here attacking.
He's not hating.
Okay, I'm attacking sin. And you guys have the opportunity whether to agree with it or not. It's actually, I'm spreading love, the love of God. Oh, yeah. It's where you obey the commandments of God.
I'm a Christian. I've been saved since seventh grade.
Doesn't seem like it.
Really?
Doesn't
seem
like
it.
Yeah, I know how you are.
Really?
You oppose the gospel and you dress it modestly. What kind of Christian is that?
She's not opposing the gospel.
Look, she's opposing what I'm saying. I am preaching the gospel. You. The Bible says this in 1 John. It says, he who is of God hears God's words. He that is not of God does not hear God's words.
Really,
there you go again. You're not a Christian either. Fake Christian.
She's completely dressed. And you're
yeah, you know what the problem is?
Christian.
You guys don't read the Bible. And you want to just... Well, then obey it and dress modestly.
But you're retarded.
I am fully covered.
Okay, you're not dressed modestly. Okay? Just like homosexuals. They think it's okay to be homosexuals. They don't. They're blinded. It's all pride. It's just you're blinded in your pride. You don't know love. You don't know hate. You're gonna go to hell if you don't repent. Look, I'm actually.
You are trying to produce a God that loves everyone.
Guess what? Guess what?
And my God loves everyone.
Guess what?
I don't know what God you serve, but my God loves everyone. If you want to,
that means I just I wash my blood off your hands.
If you want to teach,
I wash your blood off my hands.
You're trying to teach something to someone else. You don't come in and you judge them off of what they have on. What if that's the only thing she could afford? You
well,
know
it looks
that.
Pretty fancy
you
to me.
You don't know that. No, it's not.
Okay.
Not at all.
It looks like
your
she can afford other clothing. Okay.
It looks like you can afford
You can say what if, but that means nothing.
It looks like you can afford to go back to college and maybe take some Bible study classes because the shit that you are saying is wrong. And I've never once
So I can be like you guys? Go back
I've
to college and be like you?
You guys, but I've been called a whore twice by you guys.
You need to repent.
No, you guys need to repent. Because calling someone else that is God's child, exactly.
Whoremonger? Whoremonger? People that sleep around?
I have my family members.
Well, when they're not married?
You guys don't know what
you're doing. You know what? Like, you're on your way to hell. You're on your way
to hell. I'll see you there.
You can't say that.
I'll see you there.
Well, then you know you're going, but I'm not. Trust me. I'm not going. What?
I'll trust you.
Or a friend that had a different religion.
I'll trust me. You're going.
Well, obviously, if we're friends and I talk about Jesus, they don't want to hear about it. I don't want to hear about their religion either. Okay? And I don't want to hear about their boyfriend either if I'm talking to a gay guy. So it's pretty hard for us to be friends.
Real Christians can't argue with
you. You need to repent, all of you. You're going to end up in hell unless you repent and turn to Jesus.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
Okay, so God said there's sinners, and then if you sin, there's also good deeds, right? The good deeds can equal more than sins.
No, that's not how it works.
That's how it works. The good
deeds. Are you Muslim?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, that's why you...
The Bible
you,
and
no,
the
no,
Quran
you're,
are very based.
No,
based
no, no, the Bible doesn't teach that.
And one thing it does teach is that you're not the judge. He's the judge, not you.
Okay, so then why do you guys go chop people's heads off then if you're not the judge? You go kill Christians. Actually,
that's
the Bible
small-minded,
says...
small-minded, man.
That's what your Bible... That's what your Quran says, man.
Walk into.
Have you read it?
Look, I know what it... I know those Surahs. I don't need to read the whole thing.
Okay, then you can't say that you
know
it.
And the guys, the Wahhabis, the people...
You're not a judge, though. You can't
I didn't cut nobody's
people.
Heads off like your religion
you're
does,
judging
okay?
People. You're telling a girl you're not Christian. You're not Christian. Who are
well,
you to
well,
say
it's
that?
Obvious.
Who are you? Are you a priest?
Based
are,
on the Bible.
Are you a priest?
Based on
are
the
you
Bible.
A priest? No, you're not.
Okay.
You don't even know the Bible.
Well,
if I open the
you're,
Bible
you're a Muslim.
If I open up okay. the Bible and I say,
I guess,
do you know what this is? No, you don't. A priest does. So don't judge people.
You need to repent, man. Muslims go to hell too.
I'd like to say.
Muhammad's a false prophet and a pedophile. Repent.
Hey man, I'd like to say I have nothing against you, just the way you spread the message is all.
Well, you have something against me and you're wrong, okay? Look, you can sit here and try to act like you're at peace with me. You're butting up on me.
Yeah.
You're holding up a nasty sign. Don't act like you're
I am holding up a nasty sign.
Don't act like you didn't do anything wrong and now we're buddy buddy, okay?
I'm not trying to be
okay?
buddy buddy. I'm trying
okay.
to say,
well no you're wrong and you really need to repent.
No, I don't need to repent for being a dick to another dick. Yeah.
See? Not wrong there.
That's fine, but we're basing everything on the Bible, and that's
okay.
Different.
We're back.
We actually got
it. Shows you don't repent, man.
No, I'm not.
I know.
I tried to read the Bible once. It really burned my
hope.
Every time I walk like a 100 feet here at church, I have to drive past one every day.
You wouldn't even be here if it wasn't for our preaching earlier.
I died
a little bit. It's
okay. You wouldn't stop.
I walked over nice, here man. Because you're
being nice.
I was shocked because you were nice. People calling the sword and saying we're all going to hell.
It goes back to the Bible says.
Like said, we here and dressed modestly and tried to preach Jesus.
Nobody would have stopped. Not one person stopped. Well, I've done it. It's true.
That's not true. I stopped before.
Let's just be real. There's a God uses the rebuke. He just does. The Bible actually says, preach the word. It says reprove, rebuke, and exhort with all long-suffering and doctrine. The rebuking is important because, you know, it gets your attention and it makes you start thinking. You know, the Bible says the word of God, it pricks our hearts and it makes us think about where we're at. I mean, the Bible says that the false prophets speak smooth speech, flattering tongue. You know, but if you read the Word of God, it cuts you. That's why most people don't read the Bible. You're not going to want to read the Bible in your sin because it's going to cut you into your heart. You're going to be like, man, I don't want to read that. It's against me. You know what I'm saying? That's why you won't read the Bible.
I want you to realize so many people were here today compared to the other days where they walk past and yell at you because you're being nice right now and because of the gay.
My message has not changed.
Good. Okay. Stand by what you believe in, but you don't have to yell hateful words at people.
But the words are still the same. They're against your lifestyle. Well, yeah, but she's saying that because I'm not raising my voice, somehow I'm nice, but the message hasn't changed.
So no, but you aren't calling me a whore, and you aren't saying I'm going to hell.
Well, yes, I have.
Gay.
I told you that. I just did.
You have not told me saying I'm dressed like a whore.
Well, you're not dressed like a whore right now.
So she's still a whore and going to hell.
But the women who are showing their bodies are.
Wait, tell me.
They still are.
Yeah.
Well, you know, it's on different levels, okay? You know, it's like, because the more skin you show, the tighter the clothes, and the more skin you show, the more you're dressing like a whore. I mean, that's basic. My shorts are baggy, you know? I mean, they're to my knees. I mean, you know,
And it's different with a woman too, because the Bible says a woman is the glory of man. A woman is the glory of man. A woman can be made a sex object a lot more than a man can, okay? And that's why it's all the more important for women to cover themselves up.
Just because guys can't keep it.
It's both people's fault.
It's my fault that my ex-boyfriend raped me.
It's not your fault. I don't believe that. I do not believe that.
Okay.
I mean, if people are living in sin, if women are dressing provocatively, don't you see how it sexually charges men? Don't you understand that?
That is not my responsibility.
You're responsible. You are responsible.
If he comes back to me and touches me, that's not my problem.
Look. Think about it like this. Okay, if you got a pit bull and you put a piece of meat out there and say, hey, pit bull, hey, I didn't bite your arm, you're going to be like, well, shame on you.
You admit that you're like a dog and that we're just pieces of meat to you.
No, but you're...
That is the comparison.
I'm saying if you put a piece of meat out there and you get bit...
I being the meat, you being the dog.
Just don't...
rhetoric like that and say that you do not justify it.
Hey, I'm saying both are guilty, but neither one... You're not let off. I'm saying if you were the one... If the woman...
Get drunk at the party.
Yeah.
No, actually, I don't. No.
You know, women are just as conniving and evil, and they're seductresses out there. I mean, so you're all guilty. All need to repent. Every one of you. I mean, just accept that. God can change you. He can take those desires out of you. You know, if you would have grown up in my generation, I bet you probably wouldn't be gay. It wasn't popular to be gay when I was in high school. That's what you guys are being swept away in this movement that's going on right now. Most of you are being swept away. You were curious and you started getting involved in these dark things. You know, but God actually wants to give mercy. The Bible says where sin abounded, their grace abounded that much more. I was a sinner. I used to go after all the horse women, the lesbians and stuff. Well, I'm cleansed now. I've cleansed. I've been changed. I've turned. I'm telling you, I give the glory to God. I got on my face and I cried out to God. I actually had heart failure 7 years ago. And I was very sick. It would be great if you all prayed and accept Jesus, but more than that, the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 30, it says there's a generation who are pure in their own eyes, but they're not washed from their filthiness.
You're just deflecting.
It goes back to what I'm saying. The most important thing for you is to do what Jesus told the woman caught in adultery: go and sin no more. Now, it's a battle. Some sins are clearly evident proceeding to judgment. Those of others proceed afterwards. So right now, you know, the Bible says if you order your conduct aright, first thing you should do is start praising God. Start worshiping God. Say, you know, Lord, thank you that you're a good God. I'm not destroyed yet.
You're taking a pure thing like the Bible and completely soiling it.
How am I soiling the Bible? I'm telling you what the Bible says.
You're telling
the word. What am I? To tell you to turn from evil is twisting the word?
No.
That's what causes you to save your life. Look, when I tell a drunkard to lay down their alcoholism, they could be saved their life from a car accident. Don't you see that? You see a natural perspective? You might be in danger of getting pregnant and killing that baby. Having that baby's blood on your hands.
So if I'm gay, I'll get in a car accident and die.
Talking about drunkards. Drunkards. Gay people have other judgments. They have anal cancer they can get. They have, you know, AIDS. There's AIDS. Look, it's a serious thing. The Bible says God's judgments are in the earth. I don't want God's judgments for you. I fear God for you. I don't want calamity to fall on you. The Bible says that God is a help in time of trouble. You're God.
Thank you for bringing your rhetoric here.
Are you a sinner? Are you a sinner?
No, you.
What? Are you a sinner?
Are you?
I'm just asking you.
Are you?
I am not a sinner. No, I'm not a sinner. I used to be. No, the Bible says that. Hold on. Let me answer this question. Let me show you why I'm saying that. Okay. Hold on a minute. Let me explain to you. The Bible says in Colossians, Philippians, and Ephesus, says to the saints in Ephesus, to the saints in Colossae, to the saints in Philippi. In Jude, it says the Lord will come back with 10,000 of his saints. Jude. You notice how nobody's named Judas? You notice how nobody's named Judas? On a side note, who names their kid Judas? Okay, but look. I'm just telling you, the Bible says, it says that the Lord will come back with 10,000 of his saints. He will execute judgment on all of them for all their ungodly deeds, what they have done in an ungodly way, and of all the ungodly things which harsh sinners have spoken against him. So the Bible separates the sinners from the saints. I don't deserve to be a saint. If God were to mark, hold on. God has declared me a saint. The Bible says it in Colossians chapter 1 verse, hold on. Colossians chapter 1 verse 13. It says he has delivered us from the power of darkness and has conveyed us to the kingdom of the Son of his love. It says he having qualified us to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in the light. And in Psalm chapter 16 verse 3, it says to my saints who are my excellent ones in all the earth. The Bible says that a Christian is a saint. We're no longer a sinner. Now, I'm not saying that a Christian doesn't sin. There's different kinds of sin, okay? What you guys are involved in right now is what's called willful sin. You're a willful sinner right now, and there's no blessing from you. You need to repent.
I bless you with all my pagan gods.
You can't bless me. You don't have Christ. The only one who gives a blessing. And then you try to do the Catholic thing, too. You see?
Yes.
All right. Look, guys, we're going to leave. We're going to leave. Where'd Israel go?
Oh, he's also super salty about, like...
Okay, anybody have any more questions while I'm here?
No.
Okay.
You said you work a full-time job, right?
I do, yes. I am a contractor. I work very hard. Where's my witness?
First of all, I don't consent to my face being...
Doesn't matter. It's all public.
What?
No. I'll turn away from you. Go ahead.
Okay, thank you. Second of all, if you have a full-time job, why do you then spend your free time coming here and trying to save people who don't want to be saved?
Because the Bible says in Luke chapter 7, there's a woman that said who was a sinner, and she came when Jesus was at a wedding feast, and it says she stooped behind him and washed his feet with her tears and wiped them with the hair of her head and anointed his feet with fragrant oil. Now listen, so the man who was a religious man, he said in his heart, if this man were a prophet, he would know what manner of woman this is, for she is a sinner. And so Jesus said to that man, Simon, a certain creditor had two debtors. One owed him 500 denarii and another 50. He said, now when they both had nothing with which to pay him, he freely forgave them both. Which of those two do you suppose will love him more? And Simon said, the one whom I suppose he forgave more. And Jesus said, you have judged rightly. And he turned to the woman and he said, Simon, you see this woman? I entered my house. You gave me no water for my feet, but this woman has washed my feet with her tears and wiped them with the hair of her head. You gave me no oil for my head. This woman has put a fragrant oil on my feet. Therefore, I say to you, this woman's sins, though they are many, they are forgiven. For whoever has been forgiven much, the same loves much. But to whoever little is forgiven, the same loves little. So I have been forgiven much. So when I come and I give my time and I come here and I endure things, and even I've been punched, I've been jailed. I would put my life on the line for this ministry because I know that for me to live is Christ, for me to die is gain. I don't count my life dear anymore in this world. It's not about this world. I've tasted what this world has to offer, and it doesn't satisfy. Money, sex, drugs. You know, I've had popularity. I've had influence. But there's nothing like having God's Spirit, the Holy Spirit.
So there's nothing in the world like having God inside of you.
That's the difference. You can't have both.
That's,
you know,
fuck me in the ass because I love Jesus. So you'd rather have God inside of you than anything else in the world.
Listen, okay, away from your perversion for a minute, okay? Look, the Bible says that the pleasures of wickedness profit nothing, but righteousness delivers from death. You see, everything in this life that you guys are experiencing that has some pleasure in it or some enjoyment that's sin, eventually will come to nothing. The Bible says that it says the blessing of the Lord, though, makes one rich, and he adds no sorrow to it. The way of the just, it says, winds upward to escape from hell beneath. It says that the path of the just is like the shining sun, shining ever brighter under the perfect day, but the way of the wicked is like darkness. They don't know what makes them stumble. I was stumbling in my darkness. I didn't know. I thought I was having fun. I thought it was enjoyable until I actually had heart failure. I was jailed. My marriage was failing. My business.
You're not a sinner?
That was when I was a sinner. That was before. That was when I was. I can, but go ahead.
Good. So every single day.
When you're talking, I won't.
No, every single day, in the beginning of the day, we're supposed to go to God and we say, I'm a sinner and I want forgiveness. I want.
Die to yourself daily.
Daily. I die daily.
Okay. You're saying you're a saint. You're not a saint. You're a born sinner.
I believe the Bible says in James chapter 4, it says, cleanse your hands, you sinners, and purify your hearts, you double-minded. 1 Peter 4:17 says, if scarcely a righteous man be saved, where will the ungodly and sinner appear? Scarcely a righteous man. It says, if your righteousness doesn't exceed the Pharisees, you won't even enter the kingdom, Matthew 5.
I'm not talking about
I'm but the Bible condemns sinners. The Bible says in Isaac.
You're a sinner.
No, I'd be condemned. If I was a sinner, I don't practice sin. The Bible says this in 1 John chapter 3, verse 4. It says, whoever sins, it says, whoever commits sin also commits lawlessness, for sin is lawlessness. And you know the Son of God was manifested to take away our sins. In him there is no sin. It says, little children, let no one deceive you. He who practices righteousness is righteous as he is righteous. He who sins is of the devil. For the devil has been sinning from the very beginning. For this purpose, the Son of God was manifested that he might destroy the works of the devil. Yeah, I'm declared a saint in Christ. I'm a Christian. Born again Christian. And I am a saint. What makes somebody a saint? Are there not saints?
They have wings.
That exist?
They have wings.
Yeah, I kind of want to
say. No, saints are people. The Bible says in the earth. Psalm 16, verse 3. Now, who are saints, though? Who are saints? Aren't there saints? On the earth?
Are you Catholic?
No. The Bible. I don't believe in Catholicism. I'm talking. The Bible says there's saints.
Catholic Bible is what talks about saints.
And that's not true.
Yes, it does.
No, it doesn't. The regular Bible does.
It's the same Bible. It's just different.
Jude. Hey, you can say what you want. I mean, I'm just telling you. I'm cleansed from my sinner. I used to be a sinner. I used to be a porn watcher. I used to be a marijuana smoker. I used to. I'm just telling you the truth. You can try to condemn me for what I've done, but I serve God. I worship God. I have a clean conscience before God. I used to be like you guys. Then you need to walk away. Then this is public property. This is public property. No. All right. Any other questions? That's true. If you're a Christian, you are a saint. This man understands his Bible.
All the saints.
That's right. Now, it's by grace, okay? If the Bible says, in Psalms 130, I believe it is, it says, O Lord, if you should mark iniquity, who could stand? If God were to mark my sins, and if he were to search me out and judge me according to his law, I would be a sinner today. But I'm not judging. I'm under grace. I'm not under law. I'm not walking by the flesh any longer. I'm walking by the Spirit. And the Spirit, the Bible says, if we walk in the light as he is in the light, the blood of Jesus will purify us from all sin. It says that the blood of Jesus will cover us and purify our hearts by faith. Good question. The Bible says The Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 13, it says, though we walk in the flesh, we do not war against the flesh, for our weapons of warfare are not carnal, but mighty in God, to the pulling down of strongholds, to the casting down of arguments, and to the bringing into captivity. Into every thought to the obedience of Christ. Look, when I have an evil thought, because it happens, you know, things happen, you know, the women, they, but what I do is I take that thought captive and I rebuke it. The Bible says, crucify your members which are on the earth, you know, and I have no excuse. I'm held to the highest judgment, and I have moments of weakness, you know, but the issue, yeah, that's repentance. That's what repentance is.
Anybody can repent. We're all still sinners.
But the Bible says you have to turn from evil. You have to. The Bible says in Luke chapter 14, verse 33, it says, whoever he be of you doesn't forsake all that he has, and you have to renounce your sins, the Bible says. You have to vow against your sin. You have to be willing. You have to be willing to go forever without sinning. If you're not willing to do that, you can't be a Christian.
Well, you can be willing to go forever without sinning and still somehow fall through sin.
That's but the whole point is that you have to be willing to go. That's the first step, is you have to be willing to go the rest of your life without sinning. Now, it's a battle. We battle certain things.
Being a sinner and sinning is different.
That's it. Well, yes, in a way, yes.
In a way, because you Christians do sin. We don't, but the difference is in our hearts, we don't desire that sin. We may fall to sin. We may fall to temptation, but we're not desiring.
So many more people would listen to you.
Okay.
Are you going around saying that I'm a slut? And like a couple of weeks ago, you said I would get raped for the outfit that I wore.
Be safe.
I never said that.
Yes, you did.
No, I never said you'd get raped. I don't wish you to get raped, and I don't want you to happen to you. I honestly don't. I honestly want to see you preserved from that. But if you do dress inappropriately, you know, it's going to charge men sexually. They might do something stupid, and I'm not, you know, both parties are guilty. I'm not wishing or saying you deserve rape. The guy should never do it. I don't think God wishes it on you. I don't think rape is comes from God. But I'm just telling you that you know you got to do it God's way, because God's way is pure and holy and just. And like this man is saying, look, the Bible says. That there's different kinds of sin. Now, for instance, my sin, when I get judged by God, because every time I go into prayer every night and I say, God, search my heart, see if there be any wicked way in me, because I don't know my heart as well as God does. And when I sit in God's presence and I say, Lord, show me my heart, because I could be deceiving myself. And there's been times I've come out and I've preached on college campuses and left and felt guilty how I preached. But I might have said something like that. Maybe that was one of those times. And I get prayer and God convicts me. And if I did say that, I was wrong. But well, exactly. But my point is that when you maybe at the time you didn't think it was sin because you thought it was necessary, But what our conscience bears witness. Our conscience bears witness that things like sexual immorality. His sexual purity is one of the most important. It may be the most important thing when it comes to being a Christian. You know why?
I'm extending an olive branch if you take that.
Do you know why sexual immorality is so dangerous? Because the Bible says in 1 Corinthians chapter 6 that every sin that a man does is outside the body. But whoever sins sexually sins against his own body. And you do not know the Holy Spirit? You know, dwells in you, who you have, it says, and that you were bought at a price. And it says, therefore, honor God with your body and your spirit, which are His. So, you know, there's certain things that God waits
Cleveland Blue in the realm. Lead, so.
But you know, I'm not minimizing my sin because, you know, sometimes I get impatient with my wife. Sometimes I react.
God bless
my wife loves me.
I
love my wife.
What do you think he's been doing all day?
Have you heard some of the things that
he's
been
saying? No, I don't love you.
He has a wife. Yeah. He has a mother.
Confirm him, man.
My wife's a blessed woman. You know, we have a great marriage. We're one mind, one flesh. She's a preacher too. So as I was saying though, that you know, when I get impatient or angry, maybe it's not right. It's sin. And sometimes you might feel justified, but you know what? When the Lord reveals to me that it was sin, I have a job to do as a Christian. To say, God, help me repent. I can't continue in that. My sin is no worse or better than yours in this respect. That it's all sin. But if you continue to justify your sin or minimize or cover your... The Bible says in Proverbs chapter 28, verse 13, whoever covers their sin will not prosper. But whoever confesses and forsakes them shall have mercy. So you need to confess it. Confess that you're sinning, you know, and quit trying to say it's normal, okay to be gay and all these things. It's not normal. It's abnormal. It's not human. It's subhuman. It's not righteous, it's unrighteous.
There's gay animals too, you know that, right?
More the reason not to be gay. You're living like an animal. That's what the Bible says. Don't be like an
animal. Look,
the Bible says, and look, the Bible says, and look, let me do the Bible. The Bible says, 2 Peter chapter 2 says, you being like, that was good, you covered your body up. The Bible says in 2 Peter chapter 2, it says, they being like natural brute beasts, meant to be caught and destroyed, okay? So God doesn't want you to be like a natural brute beast, meant to be caught and destroyed. We were creating God's image. The Bible says I was just reading today in Revelation chapter 5. The Bible says Jesus Christ, He redeemed us from among men to be kings and priests, and that we would rule with Him on the earth. God wants us to rule with Him, not to be, you know, subject to the devil in hell. You'd be tormented in hell. You guys should watch this testimony of this guy named Bill Weiss. He had 23 minutes in hell, and the things he saw in hell. You do not want to go to hell. There's no water in hell. It's fear, no air. The Bible says so. Luke chapter 18, it says there was a rich man who went to hell. He said, touch my tongue. I'm in torment in this flame with some water. He just wanted it on his tongue. You think that would make a difference, but to him, one drop of water on his tongue would have made a difference. That's how much torment he was in. You don't want to go to hell. Trust me, I had heart failure.
I'm not.
If you're a sinner, you will.
No, I won't.
If you live in sin, you'll end up in hell. That's what the Bible says. The Bible says something else. If you're in sin,
I know where I'm going.
Okay, but the Bible says you're like a dog returning to your vomit. The Bible says,
I'm not. I know what I'm.
You're a lesbian, aren't you?
I'm not a lesbian.
No. I thought you were.
No.
I thought you said you were married. You were dating some girl.
She never said that.
Oh, okay. Well, you're somebody else. Oh, I was just asking. I thought you were.
You have heard now.
Well, but you're still a sinner, right?
Yes, but I repent. Okay. I go to church every Saturday and Sunday. I volunteer.
Okay.
I dedicate my life in seventh grade.
Okay. Is that what gets you into heaven? Is all your good works?
But I read the Bible every night. I do devotions. So who are you to tell me?
Is that what makes you saved? Because how much do you read the Bible?
My God, every day.
By the deeds of the law, no flesh will be justified in God's sight. By the deeds of the law. The Bible says, walk in the Spirit, and you will not gratify the lust of the flesh. If you're walking in the flesh, you're going to die. You're not going to go to heaven.
Prostitutes and taxpayers.
That's why I'm here. Taxpayers? You mean tax collectors?
You don't have to film these people.
Look, if you're living in sin, you're not going to end up in heaven.
You don't have to film. But you're living in sin.
I'm not. I'm not dressing immodestly.
I'm not dressing immodestly.
Well, I think you need to fear God a little more.
I don't need to fear God. God is not a fairy dog.
Hold on a minute. You're not reading your Bible then. The Bible says to fear God. It says it all throughout. The Proverbs, the Psalms, the New Testament. Why wouldn't you? Why are you skipping? Let me just ask you. Why are you skipping over those scriptures?
I'm not. You don't know what to do.
Hold on. Let me just tell you. Hold on a minute. This is a good point. This is how I got saved, okay? Hold on. You're next. Let me say this point, okay? The Bible says, Jesus Himself said in Matthew chapter 10, verse 28, said, do not fear the one who can kill the body and after that can do no more. Said, I tell you who the one you should fear. Fear him who after killing has power to cast into hell. I say to you, fear him. Luke chapter 12 and Matthew chapter 10. Jesus said to cut your hand off will cause you to sin. Better for you to have one hand to enter into life than have two hands to enter into hell. You know, Revelation 14:7. It says there was an angel preaching the everlasting gospel, said, fear God, fear God. So why would you say not fear God? It's in the New Testament.
Why didn't you cut off your hand when you were masturbating to porn? Huh?
Because God didn't want me to do that. There's an easier way. Just repent. I turn. Go ahead. Okay. Okay.
You say you're not a sinner. No, Romans 3:23.
All have sinned. Past tense.
For all have sinned and all fall short of God's.
I do. I fall short. I have sinned.
Okay. You said you don't sin.
But I walk in a way. I walk in a way that is perfect. The Bible says in Psalms 101. Hold on. Let me tell you what the Bible says. David said, look, you're just continuing, man. You can't stop. The Bible says in Psalms 101, it says, I will behave wisely in a perfect way. O Lord, when will you come to me? I will walk within my house with a perfect heart. I will set nothing wicked before my eyes. I hate the work of them that fall away. It shall not cling to me. A perverse heart I shall not know. A perverse heart shall depart from me. I shall not know wickedness. You know, when somebody becomes a Christian, they wash their hands in innocence and they depart from evil and they turn and they get a new heart. The Bible says, to the pure, all things are pure. But to the defiled, nothing is pure. You're defiled and I need to repent. You got chewing tobacco and cuss words coming out. You need the love of God. Catholicism, I don't have chewing tobacco and cuss words coming out of my mouth. It's okay for you to do those things. You're not going to bring those things into heaven. Nah, so why don't you turn from it? Why don't you receive my admonishment? Look, man. I don't just call people, if they're dressed like a whore, that's one thing. If they're sleeping around, now they're whores. If they're sleeping around, now that makes them a whore. The Bible says to warn them.
Okay.
The Bible says when you see someone living wickedly, to warn them.
Okay, I was been in the church since I was born, okay? First of all, you shouldn't be preaching hate. That's not what Jesus...
Hatred for sin, yes.
No, don't matter.
Hatred for sin. Yes, it does.
Everybody sins. You shouldn't be preaching hate.
No. If you're living in sin, you're... The Bible says all who sin... All who sin are of the devil. All who sin are of the devil, Jasmine. You're of the devil. You're of the devil if you're sinning. You're of the devil if you're sinning. I'm not walking in sin. You are the devil. You're of the devil.
She's gay. She's gay.
You're sinning. You're of the devil.
Generations from now, some of your kids will be gay.
Why won't you fear God? That's you. That's what you're missing. No, then you would turn from evil. The Bible says, by the fear of God, you're living in sin and you're proud of it. You're proud of your sin. You're proud of your, yeah. Jesus said, you're those who justify yourselves among men, but God knows your heart. Jesus said that. Why are you justifying yourself among men? I say fear God. God wants to give you grace if you'll come humbly. Get humble. Get humble and turn from your sin.
All right. Okay. Love thy neighbor. Push them gently.
This is love. This is love. This is love. What's not loving? According to the Bible, it's not loving? How can you be a Christian?
You're the one that atheists.
You can't discern the word.
Do not push them away from God.
Look, maybe God wants to bring you back, but I'm telling you right now, you need to be restored. You need to be restored to your faith. You need to come back to your first love. Come back to your first love. You're sinning. Are you not sinning?
You're sinning.
How am I sinning? Am I sinning?
Wait.
She may be sinning, but she's not a sinner.
If she's sinning, the difference is, the Bible says, look, the Bible says, if we sin willfully after receiving the knowledge of God, listen, there remains no more sacrifice for sin. Hold on. Because she's not willing to repent. She's making an excuse. She's making an excuse for her sin, man. Humble people don't say, yeah, I'm sinning, it's okay. Humble people don't say that.
Okay.
Then what are you going to do?
I pray and I ask for forgiveness, I'm saved.
Forgiveness for what? For your sinning of the same sins over and over again? Right?
She never said it's the same thing.
It's the truth, isn't it? The Bible says, as a dog returns to his vomit and a sow having washed to her wallowing in the mire. The Bible says, it would be better for you not to know the way of righteousness than having known it to have turned from the holy commandment. Which, you guys need to. This is for my protection, okay? Because you guys, I don't know what you guys want to do. Sinners do crazy things. Yes, they do.
Oh my gosh.
How is she sinning?
Cleanse your hands, you sinner. She admitted to be sinning and she was prideful about it. No, but why would you put it to tell me I'm sinning? You're telling me I'm sinning. How? Bear witness of the evil. Okay. Well, the Bible says to use righteous judgment. The scripture says, judge in the manner you be judged. I took the plank out of my own eye. If I said to you to cover your body up because you're dressed modestly and I was not covered up, I'd be a hypocrite. Yes, I'd be sinning. Okay. So stay covered up.
Okay.
So you take it.
Sweat all the time?
Yeah, it'd be better for you to sweat and do what God wants you to do.
You, Pastor,
and you should put baggy pants on. Don't wear skin-tight pants, too. Yoga pants are of the devil. Yoga pants are of the devil. Yeah, but when you can see a woman's crack, and her butt cheeks. Hey, woe to the man, woe to the woman who causes offenses. My shorts are not skin tight.
Oh my gosh!
Somebody help me.
My shorts are not skin tight, okay? I tell you the truth because I love you and I don't want you to be under God's judgment. Take it or leave it. You guys haven't been loved like this. You've never been loved biblically.
No, my dad, who's a pastor, doesn't love me.
Jesus rebukes people. Did you know the Bible says that?
What does a Christian wear to the beach?
Hey, Zeus. Hey, man, Christians are not going to be wearing thongs and bikinis at the beach.
Okay, I'm asking, what do they wear to the beach?
They cover themselves up, yeah.
What do they wear?
It's that serious. Bikinis are of the devil. Bikinis are of the devil. Listen to me. Listen.
My youth pastor's wife being considered a whore and dressing immodestly because she wore leggings.
I know.
To youth groups. Is that right? Is that what you're saying?
Listen.
I want to know.
You know. Before they could find anybody. What's your question?
You weren't even listening. Okay, listen. If my youth pastor's wife wears leggings to youth group, is she dressing immodestly and dressing like a whore?
If she's not wearing something over it, yeah, she's dressing immodestly.
I am wearing them over it.
It's tight. It's too tight.
You're comparing to dressing.
Hey, look. The Bible says, He who seeks to save his life will lose it. But whoever hates his life, I'm quoting to the Bible, and you don't. Are you saying you're a Christian?
I'm like stuck on what you said.
Okay. The Bible says he who seeks to save his life will lose it. Whoever loses their life for my sake will keep it. How am I misquoting the Bible? Word for word.
Towards the word of Jesus.
Hey man, I pull no punches. I don't want you to get. I'm not here to itch your ears. I'm not gonna itch you.
Do I have lesbian cancer?
You're not loving God.
Oh my gosh. So you just assumed that I was a lesbian, huh?
No. If you're saying lesbian is okay in any way, you're not of God.
You're agreeing
with the wicked.
You have a wife, right?
The Bible says you strengthen the hands of the wicked. You're strengthening.
It might not work. But hey,
you're strengthening. You're giving them a reason and you're strengthening their position by doing that.
Wait, so you said you have a wife, right?
The Bible says, "Who will rise against evil?"
Love thy neighbor.
You're not loving them by excusing their sin. Look. You know what the Bible says? This is the love of God. Okay. The Bible says in Leviticus 19:17, "You shall not hate your neighbor, but you shall surely rebuke your neighbor and not bear sin because of that." I don't bear your sin. I love you. I don't hate you. I rebuke you. That's what the Bible says. So do it God's way. Do it God's way and be blessed.
Amen.
Do it God's way and don't be gay.
You have a wife, right?
She's not gay.
I'm just saying in general. She's gay.
You have a wife, right?
Yes, I'm happy.
Do you guys go to the beach?
No, we don't actually. We go there to preach, but we don't go to just hang out and wear bikinis and swimsuits. I think
your wife doesn't go to the beach.
No.
I'm straight. I love
so we should never
be saying being a good Christian.
Cover up. Just wear some shorts. Wear some baggy shorts. Do it God's way. Do it God's way. Hey, look, if you want to get a tan, go in the privacy of your house where there's a fence and get a tan out back. But don't sit there and put your body out on display. It's not right.
You need to
repent and get right with God. These things will become evident to you once you really get right with God. I know right now you got other things that are worse than that that are in your life.
There's things that are a lot.
But you have to count the cost.
You should be more moderate if you want people to come and agree with you and you want to teach people. You should be more moderate.
Look. You know, these days are getting dark. The Bible says the kingdom of God suffers. Hey, look, there's a baptism. The Bible says, I'm listening to everything you're saying.
No, you don't listen.
Yes, I do. Hey, don't lie. I've listened to you. Don't listen. Don't lie.
I don't care. Don't talk to me like you're my dad. Do you want to win hearts over? Yes?
I won't talk to you then. I won't talk to you.
Good. Don't talk to me.
Look, folks, the kingdom of God suffers violence and the violent take it by force. This is love. This is the most loving thing that you guys need right now.
No, a
Christian sins in a different way. I'm not a sinner. I'm not sinning right now, I'll tell you that much. I'm not sinning right now. This is what God wants me to do. I'm doing what God called me to do today. I'm giving you the scriptures that you can judge for yourself.
Aren't you a lawyer?
No, I'm not. So repent. So repent of all your sins.
Okay, I go to confession.
No, catechisms of the devil. Yes. Yes, it is. It's lies. You're worshiping Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace. She's not full of grace. She needs Jesus. She's a sinner. Jesus was a sinner too. She needed God. That's what she said in Luke chapter 1. Catechism is man-made religion. I was a Catholic. I know what
Christianity derived from being Catholic.
No, it didn't. No, it never did. No.
Oh,
The catechism came from man. You know, they call the Pope Father. Actually, Jesus rebukes. Oh, you can don't believe everything you read on the internet.
Okay.
Believe the Bible. The Bible says that the original Christians were called followers of the way. They were called disciples of Christ. That's what the original church was.
So now I'm a sinner because I'm Catholic.
I'm a sinner.
Well, you know, you're not born again. Catholics are not born again, right? That's not being born again. If any man's in Christ, they're a new creation.
I forgot.
Right? Being born again, a baby doesn't choose to be baptized. Has no say in the matter. If any man's in Christ, it says they're a new creation. No, being born again is, look, the Bible says, I believe the word of God, and the word of God says in 1 Peter chapter 3, verse 21, says the baptism that saves us is not the washing of the filthiness of the flesh, but the answer of a good conscience towards God through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead. The answer of a good conscience comes when you repent and you believe. Amen. I got you on video. He couldn't resist. I forgive you.
What did he do? Fuck you off?
I forgive you. No, he used my bullhorn.
Aww.
He gets you getting in trouble, so you can't be using the bullhorn on him.
What is your...
What's your motive?
My motive is to obey the Bible. The Bible says, preach.
What's your motive here?
My motive, the Bible says, some water and some plant. I'm watering and planting seeds. Some of you, I'm watering this woman's seed because she already has a seed planted. I'm planting some seeds in some other areas.
You're planting seeds, but nothing.
I can do nothing against the gospel, only for the gospel. So.
I understand what you do, and I understand that
good.
You're not doing it the right way.
Okay.
You're trying, but you're like going.
I hope, hey, this is the best way. This is the best way. Okay. Do you guys want to see some preaching and teaching online? No, anybody humble? Not humble. No one's humble. That's some humility. Take it, man.
I'll go to my church for preaching and teaching.
Is this videos?
All this preaching, this whole conversation will be online. Sure you don't want it? That way you can see. Make sure I didn't change the video.
Do you have their permission to post their?
Actually, I don't need it. It's just no rights of privacy in public.
No. Technically, there's a little thing with that.
I'm not a public official, so you need
so. God bless you guys. Listen, we're here because we love you. You might not like how vehement we are.
Good. No, I can watch it and see how compared to my church, because my church is a church of God loving, not yours.
Okay, that's fine. You can take it or leave it. Hey, listen, I know I preach a hard word against sin. I know. Because that's what saved me. I needed that. The Bible, let me give you one verse, okay? The Bible says the kingdom of God suffers violence, and the violent take it by force. Men are pressing into the kingdom, folks. You got to press into the kingdom. It's a narrow path that leads to life. You see, it's not a broad way that leads to life. It's a narrow path that leads to life. That's why I preach against sin so hard.
A whole lot of money if I show up on YouTube. Let me tell you that.
Okay. All right, guys. All right. I love you guys.